Greetings, mortals. Today we talk about how death saves are my least favorite mechanic to handle death and dying in a tabletop game. Welcome to Tabletop Sandbox, where we talk about all things TTRPG. I am definitely not an alien brain slug controlling this cumbersome human flesh bag, also known as Harrison Tarr. If you like content like this, please subscribe so you don't miss it in the future. Now, I don't like death saves, but not because of the mechanic itself, but rather due to the style of play that it encourages and the styles of play that it discourages or makes impossible. In 5th edition Dungeons & Dragons, the player characters are basically superheroes, or at the very least, action heroes. They are just as effective at one hit point as they are at 100 hit points. There's no apparent penalty for withstanding injuries until you drop to 0 hit points and are knocked unconscious. It also skews healing so that waiting until someone drops to 0 hit points and then healing them is always more valuable than healing them when they're already up and moving. Because they're just as effective at 1 and 100 HP, it doesn't make sense to give them much healing until they drop unconscious. Also, with no penalty of being beaten, bled, or burned into literal incapacitation, when you pop right back up at one hit point. All these things combined mean that death is the only defeat. At least the only defeat that is encouraged by the game's mechanics. Sure, you can have a GM come up with other ways to force your players to surrender by presenting them with insurmountable odds or by threatening something that they care deeply about in-game, but none of that is encouraged by the mechanics of 5e. And finally, when death does occur, which is an uncommon occurrence, it's not dramatic. And we all know how much I love drama. Ironically, with all these mechanics of the game, 0 HP does not feel close to death. Think about how many times have you had a player character drop to 0 HP? And of those times, how many times are they healed almost immediately versus how many times do they actually die? By the time a character reaches 10th level, it's got to be at least a dozen times that they've hit 0 hit points and not died. Oftentimes, there's not even any fear of death because you have a healer there that can heal you within one or two turns. And when death does occur, it's either because you ran into a TPK where you're left with everybody either straight up killed by the enemy or making death saves without any help. The TPK can be dramatic, but usually it's just frustrating. And when you accidentally roll a natural one, well, sometimes that can just feel cheap, especially if you going unconscious has happened dozens of times before. Why does it make sense that now, of all times, now is when you die? Seems like dumb luck rather than the consequences of dropping to 0 HP. A time when death in 5e can feel dramatic is when the DM decides to go out of their way and kill one of the player characters. They might do this because they think your actions deserve this consequence, or they might be doing it to make a point that this is a really vicious villain and he kills without remorse. The DM might be going out of their way to establish this villain as truly evil by targeting one of the players and performing a coup de grace on this adventurer while the other adventurers watch. But I don't think it feels fair or right for the DM to be the one deciding when a player character dies. It feels out of the ordinary and not like something that could just happen in the normal course of play. I think that while character death should be a part of your game and a real threat, it should occur as a natural course of play, not just because the DM decided to make a point. And I think most GMs would agree that they want death to be a part of the game, but they don't want it to be something that they just arbitrarily decide when it happens and who it happens to. And again, a GM going out of their way seems like the only reliable situation to introduce the threat of death into your games. It's just not something that's encouraged to be common by the rules of D&D 5e. Now, of course, this is just my opinion. And me having qualms with the mechanic of death saves doesn't mean that it's bad game design. But if you agree with the observations I've made about it, and you're not a huge fan of them either, I have some advice that might be interesting to you. Don't fight it. Don't change it. If you're playing 5th edition Dungeons & Dragons, don't change the way death saves work. First of all, changing a mechanic that is so fundamental to the game would be a lot of work. Also, it would subvert the expectations of your players when you tell them that you're running a game of 5e. If they come in and they're playing a game that only slightly resembles the 5e that they know, they could be pretty upset. It's very important to establish expectations with your players. Don't fight against 5e. Embrace it. Play the game that the mechanics encourage you to play. Let the players be action heroes or superheroes that can almost never die. But if that's not the type of game you want to run, don't change the game you're playing, change the system that you're using. Play a system like Dungeon World or any other of the Powered by the Apocalypse systems, where when you hit zero, you have a high chance of dying immediately. Or something like the OSR, where life is historically cheap and death comes easy. If you disagree, why don't you leave a comment so we can have some titillating and erudite discourse? But I digress. Good night, mortals, and don't forget to sub... Ugh. Where am I?